I'm holding the new T20 wedges. I've got an old T7, which I know is one of our more popular wedges out on tour. T20, we took a lot of that teardrop shape and brought it into it, but we wanted to do a couple things on the weighting of it as well. So if you look at these, they're a little bit thicker on this upper portion. Try to bring a little bit more mass up, so that especially when you're in the higher lofted ones, so you can get a little bit more of that low checking ball flight out of it. When you get into this weaker lofted, the gap wedges, the pitching wedges, doesn't have as much mass up here, but it has that traditional teardrop shape you're used to. And then you see, this is an old one, but that's the blue finish. We've actually got a blue, a raw, and a chrome as well. So I know I've got each of yours. I got your chrome and I got your raw.
Well, the main difference to me was how the hosel kind of flowed more into the bottom groove here. In the T7s, it had it was a little bit more for some reason toward the toe. Mm-hmm. This one's very squared. It looks a lot more, I guess, even when it's square and when it's open, it kind of can transition very well, especially in a 60 degree or 58. A lot of guys like to open their face a little bit, so that transition between the hosel up into the first line really helps it look a lot better when you open the face.
This is my first time having a Mizuno wedge, so I didn't notice a ton looking down at it, but once I put it on the ground, I could see that it sat really, really flat on the ground, which I like. I don't want something where the leading edge is going to get in the way. I want something that's really going to glide right underneath that ball. So for me, that's what I look for mostly, and that's what I like about this one.
Wedges are so personal. Just that's why you'll see different shapes from different manufacturers, a round shape or a teardrop shape. And that's really where the T and the S series and the R series came from. But the predominant look for a better player has been that teardrop. And you want one that when you open it up, it doesn't look kind of odd, doesn't look offset when you open it up. So kind of how you were describing the way that leading edge transitions makes a lot of sense, something we were trying to dial in for the look of it.
Yeah, I think wedges are so personal because there's not very much technology in a wedge in terms of making a ball go farther or having more ball speed and shaft flex and a lot of MOI. It's literally a wedge. I have to use my 59, 60 degree wedge so many different ways: square face, open face, fairway, rough, bunker, from 5 yards, from 85 yards, and most other club in your bag, you only have one stock shot. And so that's why I think wedges are so important, that you need to be able to hit it in so many different circumstances. And that's why grind and look is so very important.
It's all about versatility and predictability, that right. It's not gonna change when you open it up. It's not gonna launch different. It's not gonna do something odd. So you're exactly right about that.
I think I like bounce when the face is square and I'm hitting a fuller shot, because with a wedge, you're gonna usually take a bigger divot. So you need a little bit more bounce. So if you look here, mine's definitely a little bit higher right here than most. Just because when I am coming down with a square face, I'm gonna take a divot. But this part here is shaved on the back so that when I open the face, it doesn't stick too high off the ground and I get too much of that, because I'm not hitting it as hard and I'm not gonna take as big of a divot. It's just more of a sweep. So that's why that's shaved down back there.
And that's something you pointed out in particular, is about how it sits on the ground when you open it up, because we really tried to make sure you bevel off a lot of this trailing edge, because you're right, the last thing you want is to open it up when you're trying to hit something high and all of a sudden that leading edge lifts off the ground.
Yeah, exactly. For me, even from 60, 70 yards sometimes, I'm opening that face up just a little bit. And with this one, I feel like I can do that and I'm not going to get any type of lift off that ground. And I really feel like I can make good clean contact with the ball.